Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I'm going to do a little bit of a comparison between Python and C++. And it's a little bit of clickbait, but it's also a real comparison, so I hope you stick around for it. Now, before I continue, I do want to remind you to check out the description of this video because a lot of stuff happens behind the scenes where I collaborate with you all on GitHub to come up with ideas and prioritize the topics for this channel. Although sometimes I just do the things that I want to do, and that's what I do to keep myself sane while running a YouTube channel. So I've been playing lately with Game of Life, Conway's Game of Life, in fact, and if you're not familiar with it, then there are infinitely many resources for you to actually play with it and read on Wikipedia and all of those things, and we can play and watch an animation here, and this one's got a little bit of a time lag thing going on to show you where cells used to be active. But the basic idea is that there's simple rules for whether or not a cell becomes active, stays alive, or dies, depending on how many neighbors it has. And the algorithm for this can be quite simple. So I have a version written in C++ that I have the cellular automata struct type. I have not gone out of my way to make this the most efficient version for C++ possible. The concept is pretty straightforward here. I have a next member that makes a copy of the current state, and then it loops through every single element, counting its neighbors, and then checking to see if the element that we are currently updating survives or is born or dies, updates the result, and then returns that copy back out. Now, if you're paying close attention here, you may notice that I am in fact using a vector of bool, and you know what? It's actually working all right, so I stuck with it. But this is the C++ implementation. Now, what I did was I took this exact same implementation and I applied it to Python as well. I did the exact same algorithm. I took the C++ code, I copied it into a Python file, and I updated it to be Python. So it's the same exact algorithm. And I know that there's going to be better ways to implement this in both Python and in C++, but I wanted to do an apples to apples comparison as much as possible. And then when it is done, it prints out the current state. So I am running for 10,000 iterations. I have a 40 by 20 grid, and I have a single glider in it. And it executes for 10,000 iterations and then prints the result. And yeah, I'm compiling with full optimizations because again, we're trying to compare what's actually possible here. I'm doing very, very simple timing right here. That executes in 0.08 seconds. That's pretty consistent, 0.08, 0.09 seconds. And I have the equivalent, as I already stated, life.py, and it has a point type, an automata type, and it has the exact same way that neighbors are counted, and the same way that rules are evaluated, and the same idea of a next function that doesn't mutate the self, it just updates the return value and returns that, and then I have the same rules, the same size, 40 by 20, a glider at the same place, I execute for 10,000 iterations, and then I print the results. So if I were to run this with just the default CPython, let's go ahead and time it. There we go. It took 67.83 seconds. So a little over a minute, which is, shall we say, considerably slower than the C++ version. So we had 0.08 seconds versus 67.83 seconds. That makes the C++ version 847 times faster. Now, I know that you're sitting here going, but no one who cares about performance would have written code in that way, or they wouldn't have just used the regular CPython implementation. They would have used something like PyPy, and you're correct. This is a JITted implementation of Python. So let's execute that. Let's execute PyPy 3. Look at that, 3.94 seconds. So for this particular example, PyPy is 17 times faster than CPython and only 50 times slower than C++. That's pretty good. But in my experimentation, it's not as good as we could get. Now, hopefully you watched the episode of C++ Weekly that I recently aired about CPPYY with trivial interaction between C++ and Python. And I have an example of that here as well. The Python file is pretty simple. In fact, it fits in one screen here with my incredibly large fonts. I have import CPPYY. I import some, actually that array is no longer useful in this code, that was in a previous version. Anyhow, I create the automata object with the same rule set, a 40 by 20. I add the glider for 10,000 iterations, I execute it, and then I print out the results. And it shares a version of the C++ implementation that is almost exactly the same. I had to change a couple of things because I only had C++ 17 available to me, not C++ 20. And well, it turns out that passing like a standard array of bools to this thing was way more difficult than I expected it to be. So I created a version that takes a vector of bools and I pass a vector, but that doesn't matter very much. It only impacts the startup cost. And then we execute it for 10,000 times and it does exactly the same thing as the C++ version and the Python version before it. So let's go ahead and run that. And I'm going to go back to CPython here because I've had a little bit of difficulty in getting PyPy working with CPPYY, even though it's supposed to be a natural match, just isn't working for me. So let's go ahead and show this version first. All right, 2.15 seconds. So that's what? Yeah, so 2.2 seconds versus 4.07 seconds. That's about 2 times fast again. So now we're getting to the realm of pretty close to the C++ version. Now at 27.5 times slower. But the key point here is that all of that cost that we're paying is startup cost. We can modify this one so that instead of 10,000 times we're executing, let's execute 20,000 times. And we're not going to see the time double to 4.4 seconds or something like that. So it's definitely doesn't scale linearly. And if we could get PyPy working with this, then we would expect to see better performance again. I'm just going to go ahead and show you the error message that I get, which tells me that I have an unqualified reference to a constructor name rather than a type in this context, which is wrong. It's giving me a C++ error that makes no sense here right now. But we've got JITted Python is so much faster than regular CPython. But again, this CPPYY module for Python is proving itself to be quite powerful and with pretty darn good performance. So hopefully, if there's anyone here who's more of an expert on these tools than I am, be sure to check out the repository and figure out what I am doing wrong with trying to use PyPy 3 with my CPPYY integration here and why that isn't going right. Hello, future Jason here. Shortly after recording this episode of C++ Weekly, I realized that I had done a bit of a disservice to the Python code here. In my attempt to keep it the same as the C++ code, I actually missed something rather important. And it comes down to this right here. Every single time I make a call to count neighbors, I am re-instantiating a neighbors object. Now, since this is a tuple, if I understand my Python correctly, I'm definitely still learning Python things, then that is immutable, and I thought that the Python runtime would have moved this into some sort of a constant or something or another, which, well, it didn't. So if I move this to being a class object so that it only gets initialized once, then we see a bit of a performance difference here. So I'm going to do that. So as you can see, the change was pretty simple here. I just moved this up to something that gets initialized at the class scope, which is not at the object scope, but to reference it, I still have to do self.neighbors, and then here we go. Our count neighbors gets considerably simpler. So let's go ahead and just rerun both tests so that we can see the full difference here. Okay, that's 52-ish seconds for the pre-version with Python 3. I think that's pretty close to the result that we got earlier. And I'm going to do PyPy 3. And that's 3.16 seconds on this run. And this is very not scientific, right? But let's go ahead and move this to here so that we're at the class scope. And then we'll rerun those two tests and see what timing we get. Okay, so 43 seconds versus, what did we just have? 52 seconds. That's a pretty significant difference. And let's run this against PyPy 3 so that we can try to do apples to apples to Python's comparisons. All right, that went from 3.16 to 2.6 seconds. And yeah, there's a fair bit of variability here, particularly when we get to these smaller numbers. But I think we can go ahead and pop up a graph now on the screen and show you all the different timing results that we got for C++ versus Python versus Python versus Python with C++ inside it. So hopefully this was a helpful update. Now, you may have noticed that there's another version over here, and it is a codon version, but we can't talk about that yet. I have one more episode of C++ Weekly that I need to record and air before we can talk about this particular version. Makes for an interesting story. Thanks for watching.